God, dear, what a long title that is. The role of carbs, fat, protein, vitamins and minerals. Okay, fine. I've got an image here. You've probably got a little feeling for it already. It's the Eat Well Guide or the Eat Well Plate. It expresses to us a balanced diet. So before we go any further, I just want to bring that concept to you, balanced diet, and give you a few proportions, all right? So to be clear, I'm talking about balanced diet here in terms of proportion before we get into some of the specifics of these nutrients. So first point I'd like to make with you is the following, is that when we take our carbs, remember those carbs, our carbohydrates, you guys are studying this extensively in your biology. I know you know all about this substrate. I know you know about its breakdown in simple sugars. I know you know about your carbohydrates and the duodenum. I know that. We're going to skip over all of that today. And we're simply going to make sure that you are aware what carbohydrates do. And also that in our diet, we should be, on average, depending on specific dietary choice, looking at 55 to 60% of all nutrition, sorry, of all energy available via carbohydrates, okay? So when we talk about carbohydrates, we're talking about this group here, and a proportion of this group here too, okay? So a lot of the nutrition we get from carbohydrates also comes from fruit and vegetable, okay? So just be aware of that. We're talking about both groups there. But the majority proportion of our diet is going to come from carbs. Secondly, guys, let me give some kind of pink here. Secondly, we want to also take on fats. And again, you guys are studying lipids in detail in biology, and we're going to sort of scoot over that a little bit here, but we are summarizing, I suppose might be a better way of putting it, that 25 to 30% of all energy is derived from fats, okay? So this is not a negative thing. The good fats, appropriate fats, are really actually quite positive for us if, of course, we're relatively active. So we've got a significant proportion of energy coming from fats, and human beings process fats aerobically, okay? So we're able to do that, okay? We look at aerobic respiration in terms of glucose breakdown, but it can be done from a fuel source of fats as well. That's for another day altogether. And finally, guys, I mean, it's not our only nutrient, but we're looking at proteins. Again, something that you know well. And I know you can tell me, look, James, I know about amino acid chains. I know how they're broken down. I know they're from insoluble to soluble. I know that they can be acted on by things like pepsin in the stomach. I know that, but we're going to skip all of that, right? We're simply going to say 15 to 20% of our nutrition should come from proteins in our diet, okay? So thinking about things like pulses, fish, meat, dairy, these sorts of foodstuffs are going to bring about this protein. Now, what I want to do, though, is I want to focus on each of these groups, all right? So you see in my title here, I've got carbs, fat, protein, vitamins, and minerals. Okay, good. Well, let's focus on these. I want to initially talk about carbohydrates, okay? Carbohydrates, what are they and what do they do? All right, so nice. Let's keep this super simple. What are they and what do they do? So I'm going to give you here maybe 3 or 4 points per nutrient. So first of all, we can describe them as sugars. You will know that carbohydrates are broken down in the presence of carbohydrates into simple sugars so they can be absorbed. It's your biology stuff. But they're also starches, or they start as starches, okay, longer chain molecules which need to be broken down. Now, we would say that, or one way of describing this is that they are the preferred, in inverted commas, energy source for all activities at all intensities. And your exam board would like me to tell you that. So therefore, I'm telling you it. If we ever had a chat about it, I might tell you something slightly different. But we're arguing that carbohydrates are the fundamental source of energy for movement, all right? So that's the point I would make more broadly. And that's true. Once we start moving with any kind of intensity, it is absolutely the case that carbohydrates, specifically glucose, they are the fundamental building block of our energy release, okay? So that makes a lot of sense. Just maybe hear my voice, what I'm saying about how reliable that overall comment is. There are further courses and things to study in the future. Let's put it that way. I also want to talk to you about fats. Okay, you will know these as lipids. Let me put that in just so you make that direct connection. I know you know your glycerols from your fatty acids. So let's just put fats in there. Now, fats come from two sources, okay? They come from animals. We already know sort of 25 to 30%. They come from animals and they come from plants. Now, in the main, with a couple of specific exceptions, healthy fats come from plants in the main. And in the main, with a couple of exceptions, less healthy fats come from animals. Now, just bear in mind, there are certain animals that contain really essential oils, particularly fish, particularly oily fish, that you can only get from that source. So just be aware of that. But as a general sort of rule of thumb that you might want to consider. The second point is that they carry, I think I did a different color here, more energy than carbs. So fats are actually more energy dense than carbohydrates. So just be aware of that. But they are very good for powering a low intensity energy, which is one of the reasons why I was slightly cagey about this point over here. Okay, I'm not going to get into it, but they're are kind of low intensity sort of fat burning types of activities. They will be driven by lipids, by fats. Let's keep going. We're almost there. Let's now talk about proteins. I haven't left myself enough space, so let me expand this a little bit. But proteins, again, proteins are a structure you know well from your biology studies. Your amino acid chains. You guys obviously know about synthesis in the ribosomes and so on. But nevertheless, we want to focus here that proteins are consumed for growth. Particularly, I mean, think about growth in two contexts. Of course, we could be talking about children and children getting bigger and stronger and bones elongating and various other bits and bobs. But we could also be talking here about what we might refer to as the adaptation process. You know, if we train over time, you know, extended periods of time, I don't mean in an individual session, but weeks and months, adaptations will take place, physiological changes. And this is a description of growth. We also know that proteins are particularly important for repair. So any damaged tissues included, a muscle tissue becomes damaged because of intense exercise, protein's going to be involved in their repair. And of course, proteins also build what? Muscle tissue. I mean, a great way to describe muscle tissue is that there is a series of contractile proteins. I mean, that's literally what it is. And my final thing for today, guys, over here, we're going to group together vitamins, and minerals. Let's just lump them together. Vitamins and minerals. What should I tell you about these? I mean, the journey is long, guys. I'm going to tell you that. Although there's certain principles that are good to know. So my main point about the consumption of vitamins and minerals is that they are good for the for maintaining efficiency. Okay? Maintaining efficiency of body systems. Now, we could look at a couple of examples. We could look at minerals such as calcium, for example, crucial for the construction of cells in bone, say. That's really important. We could look at all kinds of minerals, phosphorus, magnesium, sodium. I mean, many minerals that are important in also muscle function and nerve transmission as well. And with vitamins, I mean, the journey is so long there that we're apparently not going to start it here. But again, if I just summarize for you that vitamins are good for maintaining efficiency of body systems, it appears we need to leave it there. But that's what we that's where we are right now, and that is the role of carbs, fats, proteins, vitamins and minerals. Cheers.